Hi Preschool, today my story is called Hick, and as you can see, this story has got a pig as one of the characters. So let's find out what happens. Snuffletrump the piglet was sad. Everyone seemed to have forgotten it was his birthday today. No cards, no presents, just the hiccups. Mummy Pig and Daddy Pig were very busy. When Snuffletrump asked if he could help, all that came out was, "Oink, you go off and play," Daddy Pig told Snuffletrump. But Snuffletrump was too sad to play, so he went to visit Cow instead. When Cow heard Snuffletrump's hiccups, she said, "Goodness me!" Cow told Snuffletrump that the only cure for hiccups was to drink a glass of her milk while standing on your head. But it didn't help. Poor Snuffletrump. Now he had the hiccups, no happy birthday, and milk all over him. "Thank you for trying to help, Cow," he said. Over at the hen house, the naughty, pecky, gossipy hens laughed when they heard Snuffletrump's hiccups. "Everyone knows what you cock-a-doodle-do to cure the hiccups," said Rooster with a glint in his eye. "You must juggle some eggs." "Really?" Snuffletrump wasn't so sure, but he didn't want to be rude. He started to juggle the eggs. Splat, splat, splat. Snuffletrump now had hiccups, no happy birthday, milk all down his face, and egg on his head too. Snuffletrump didn't feel like saying anything to those mean old hens, but he remembered his manners. "Thank you for trying to help," he said. Snuffletrump sat down feeling very sad and alone. "Mummy Pig, Daddy Pig," he cried, "I feel like a pancake." He looked all around, but poor Snuffletrump couldn't see Mummy Pig or Daddy Pig anywhere. Horse whined to Snuffletrump from the field. Snuffletrump trotted over. "Don't worry," said Horse. "The best cure for hiccups is a good old jiggity jog. Climb up onto my back." Snuffletrump sat on the horse's back and then jigged and jogged and bumped and bounced all around the field. It was wonderful fun. Until Horse saw Mole poke his head up and stopped in surprise. Poor Snuffletrump was catapulted through the air. "Whee!" "Thank you for trying to help, Horse," Snuffletrump said. "But now I have hiccups, no happy birthday, milk all down my face, egg on my head, and straw stuck everywhere." Dear. Duck quacked at Snuffletrump from the pond, where she was teaching her ducklings to swim. "Oh, Snuffletrump," she said, "I heard your hiccups from over here. You frightened my ducklings." "Quack." "Sorry, duck," said Snuffletrump. "Don't you know that the surest cure for hiccups is a splash of cold water?" Duck said. With that, Duck and all her ducklings started splishing and splashing Snuffletrump. When they had stopped splashing, Snuffletrump stood and waited. Duck and her ducklings waited. "Oh," Snuffletrump said at last with a smile, "I'm clean again. Thank you, Duck. Thank you, ducklings. My hiccups have still not gone." Snuffletrump was clean, but he still had no happy birthday and he still had the hiccups. Then Snuffletrump saw Mummy Pig and Daddy Pig waving to him from the barn, so he headed over there as fast as he could. "Happy birthday! Happy birthday, Snuffletrump!" Mummy Pig and Daddy Pig and all of the Snuffletrump's friends were in the barn with the biggest happy birthday party he had ever seen. Snuffletrump found out what the nicest possible cure for hiccups is: a surprise. The end. Ah, that was a nice story, wasn't it? What a fantastic surprise to have at the end. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.